नमस्कार, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर दीप्ति बिष्ट, प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कार्य चिकित्सा, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेद साइंसेज, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर. इन टुडे सेशन फॉर क्लास बीएमएस फोर्थ ईयर, आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द सेशन ऑन श्वेत रोग. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द सेशन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इंट्रोडक्शन. Ayurvedic descriptions of Shvetra and Kilas are usually synonyms. Shushrut explains that Kilas is a variety that affects only skin. Supporting his opinion, Madhav and Bhagwat view that Kilas is stable or nirdisht as it remains at skin level, called the Tawgat condition in Ayurveda. While explaining Shvetra Rog, Acharya Charak has said that Shvetra becomes firmly established when the doshas enter different levels of dhatu, indicated by change in color of the region. When dosha enters dhatu, the disease shows poor prognosis, that is asadhi avastha. Now in Ayurveda, discoloration of the skin is known as Shvetra or Kilas, meaning thereby the normal whitish color of the skin is lost and white patches seen on the skin surface. As we all know that all types of kush in Ayurvedic texts are considered tridoshas in nature, Shvetra is a type of chronic illness. Gene Kushtro, the lesions of Shvetra being dry and also non-infectious, thus it differs from the Kusht in general clinical features. It has been described along with Kusht in Ayurvedic classics. Classification of Shvetra Roga. According to etiology, Shvetra Rog can be divided into two groups according to Acharya Vagbhat. First is Agni Dagdaj and second is Anagni Dagdaj. Acharya Bhoj has divided it into two types according to the etiology. First one is Doshaj, that is Atmaj, which is related with Doshas, and Paraj, predisposition of context factor. So Doshaj type of Shvetra is again classified into Atmaj and Paraj type. Another type is Vranaj, which is caused by improperly healing of wounds. According to origin disease, Charak, while dealing with Ashtanindriya Purush, described about Ati Gaur Varna as one among these eight, can be considered as congenital Shvetra. According to Acharya Bhagwat, faulty dietics of the mother, an insufficient fulfillment of the desire of a pregnant mother can lead to congenital Shvetra in the body. Thus, keeping these references into consideration, Shvetra can be divided into two types. First one is Sahaj, that is genetically transmitted. Second one is Jatottar, that is acquired. According to pathogenesis, we can considered it first one in consideration of the vitiated doshas, that is, if it is water, then it will be reddish in color and causes horrification of hairs of the lesion. If it is pitted, then patches will be white, smooth and thick. In consideration to the fraction of doshas with dosh-dosha samuchana, it is called kilas when it affects Rakta Dhatu, and it is called Darun when Mans Dhatu is affected. Now, according to clinical features, on observation of color changes, Arun Varna happens when Vat involves Rakta Dhatu, Tamra Varna is seen when Pitta involves the Mans Dhatu, and Shvet Varna is seen when Kapha involves the Medha Dhatu. So, on observation of color changes, again, Shvetra can be classified into three types. Another one is according to distribution of patches. If it can be eight deshas, where patches found at one part of the body, and sarvadeshas, where patches found on different part of the body. Sometimes patches are isolated or not united, which are stationary, indicating the progressive nature of the disease. Another classification can be done according to prognosis of the disease, that is sadhya or curable and asadhya incurable. So these were all the detailed classification of Kshetra Rog. Now coming towards Hetu, that is etiological factors. Etiological factors of Kushta Rog described by different acharyas are as follows. General factors are such as positive factors of Kshetra also. In Atharva Ved, any factors causing vishesha of dhatu, rakt, man, meda, and asti is a positive factor for both kilas and palitam. According to Acharya Chara, lack of rajapit is the cause of pigmentary disorder of the skin. Incompatible cilias are the positive factors of kilas rog, and factors causing vishesha of blood are positive factors of Kshetra Rog. According to Ashtang Hriday, excessive intake of kaph karak dravyas can lead to Kushta Rog. Kshetra is garbhaj disorder according to Ashtang Hriday, and the disease is said to be caused by faulty dietics of the mother or insufficient fulfillment of the desires of a pregnant mother. Acharya Jarak told the following factors mainly responsible for occurrence of Kshetra. First is Vachasmi Atatyani, yani telling lies, Kritagna Bhava, indebtedness, Suranam Ninda, insulting to divine souls, Guru Darshanam, disobedience to teachers, Pap Kriya, sinful act, Purva Kritam Cha Karma, sinful act of previous birth, Virodhi Cha Anna, incompatible diet. So these are various factors as described by Acharya Charak for occurrence of Kshetra Rog. Now coming to the Samprapti Ghatak. Doshas which are basically involved are Vat, especially Udan Vat, Dushya, Rat, Rakt, Mans and Meda, Srotas, Rasvaha Srotas, Raktvaha, Mansvaha and Medovaha. All the four types of Srotas are involved. Srota Dushti Lakshan is seen as Sang and Vimarg Gaman. Marg, this is a Bahya Rog Marg. Gati is Priyak. Adhishtan is Swacha. And nature of the disease is Chirkari. Now Samprapti. The disease Kshetra is a Bahya Rog where internal environment of the body is markedly hampered. In various Ayurvedic classes, it is described as a Kidoshir Vyadi where Pitta is excessively vitiated. According to Acharya Sanhita, the three doshas being vitiated affect the Dvak, Rakt, Man and Lasika. Thus, these seven are the pathogenic materials of leprosy or Kushta Rog and other skin disorders. Henceforth, seven types that is Mahakusht and 11 types that is Shudra Kusht arises. According to Shushra Sahita, the aggravated Vayu in combination with the aggravated Pitta and Kapha enter into the Sira, which transversely spread over the surface of the body. Thus, the enraged Vayu deposits the Pitta and Kapha in the skin through the medium of their channels and spreads them over the entire surface of the body. The regions of the skin in which the affected doshas are deposited become marked with patches. The doshas thus lodged in the skin continue to aggravate and having been neglected at that contaminated the fundamental dhatu of the body. Now purvuru, which you are seeing, are parsh agyatvam, arthat loss of touch sensation, with a swain, excessive sweating or absence of sweating. There may be vavarnya or color change. There may be coat, that is rashes, lomhash, horripilation, kandu itching, toes, that is piercing type of pain, shram, klam, vranam adhikam shulam, shivru utpattish, churiskit. That means early manifestation along with chronicity. There may be daha and suptangata, that is numbness. These were the puru. Now color, group. First is color of the patches can be shade, that is white. Paravat, that is red. Tam, that is coppery or arunvan. Another lakshan is parisravi, that is exudative in nature. There may be sadhanam, rukshita, snigdhita, parusham, loss of hair follicles, that is rom udhvansi, paridhvansi, mandal, ghan or behlam. These are the roots of the shvitra roga. Now sadhya, sadhita or prognosis. Shudra rog is considered sadhya according to Acharya Chara. It is curable if it has no red or thin tail and not very old, possesses mild swelling in its middle part. Ashtangridha says Shudra is curable which is thin. The color of the hair of the area has not been changed into white. The patches are not merged with each other. Not quite old and have not been caused by burn. Shvitra rog is considered asadhya according to Charaksanta. The shvitra in which the patches exist too nearly that these cannot be differentiated from one another. Patches are numerous in number. Hair of that area has been changed into red color and duration of disease is more than 1 year is not curable. Again, the shvitra in which patches are mixed with one another, if it occurs in lips, palms, plantar surface of the feet and genital organs, hair have changed into red color and if it is caused by burn, then it is incurable. Now management. Principal management of shvitra rog, that is chikitsakar. So treatment of shvitra has been divided into two types. First one is Sanshodhankar and second one is Sanshumankar. For Sanshodhankar, patient should be treated with Snehan, Vedan, Vaman and Virechankar according to the nature of disease, according to the doshavastha of rog and doshavastha in patient. After the Sanshodhankar, Sanskrit Karm should be applied. For Sanskrit Karm, the patient should be subjected to Virechan Karm by Malapi Rath along with Gur. He should then be anointed with oil or he should be massaged with oil, that is Snehan Kriya is done, and then he is exposed to sun according to his or her tolerance. By the time when he feels appetite or thirst, prayer should be given for 3 consecutive days. Then quarts of Palapi Swap and Akshi Swap with Bakuchi Kalk may be given to drink, followed by exposure to sunlight and when blisters form. After blister formation, Chakra without salt may be allowed to taste with meat. Then Bhringraj can be taken, fried in paste. It should be kept in iron container and boiled milk is given to drink. Internal use of Gomutra Arisht is also told by Acharya Bhagwat. So these are all the steps of Sanshodhan Karma which should be done after the Sanshodhan Karma of the Rogi. Now, dhatuka chikitsa, that kush is situated on skin, shodhan and alepan should be done. If it incumbent in blood, then shodhan, alepan, kashayapan, rakhmokshan should be done. That kush reaches in mans dhatu, then shodhan, lepan, kashayapan, rakhmokshan, asavarisht, mans and prash should be used. When kush is situated in medo dhatu, sanshodhan and rakhmokshan karm should be done. And bhallatak, shilaji, swarnamakshi, guggul, agru, tvak, khadir, asan, and ayaskriti, etc. should be advocated. When kush reaches in asti dhatu, it becomes asadhya. In ashtang sangrah, it has been described that patient of shudra should be asked for vaman karm at fortnight interval. Virechan after every 1 month, Shiro Virechan after 3 days, and Raktamokshan after every 6 months. Treatment of Shudra can be summarized as follows. Langan Chikitsa, including 7 types of Shaman and 5 types of Shodhan. Sanshodhan, especially Virechan, Raktamokshan, Kashayapan, internal drug administration, then Alepan and Sunrise Chikitsa. So, these are the simple steps which are usually done in Shudra Rog Chikitsa. Then Acharya Charak has mentioned 10 dravyas which are considered as Kushtagna. These are Khadir, Haripuki, Amalki, Haridra, Bhallata, Saptapan, Aravat, Kaner, Vidang and Jati. Dhatus which can be used are Spatik, Kasi, Parat, Gandhak, Manashila. Mutra of 8 kinds which are described in Ayurvedic classics, namely the urine of sheep, goat, cow, buffalo, elephant, camel, ass, horse are indicated in Kushtarog Chikitsa. For external or topical application, Manashila Adi Lep, Ayurvedic Adi Lep, Rukla Adi Lep, Karn Pushpa Adi Lep, Nilotpal Adi Lep, many kinds of lep are available which can be applied. Then there are many tail preparation which can be used externally. These are Marichi Adi tail, Mahamarichi Adi tail, Subra tail, Kanakshiri tail, Jyotishmati tail, Somraji tail, Shudravi tail, Kushtabhu tail, etc. Some Abhyantar Priyog Dravyas are Kwas like Dhatri Khadir Kwas, Manjishta Adi Kwas, or Khadir Kwas, Patol Mool Adi Kwas. Chun which can be used, Panchanimbadi Chun, Tripla Chun, Somraji Chun, Bakuchi, etc. Some examples of Vati, Shashi Lekha Vati, Vyosh Adi Vati, Avalbuj Adi Vati, Amrita Gugun, Grits which are used, Mahanit Grits, Vajra Grits, Tikt Shatpal Grits, Mahatikta Grits, Panch Tikta Grits, etc. Asavarish, Khadirarish, Sarivadyasa, Madhvasa, Kanak Bindwarish, etc. Ras preparation, Ras Manikya, Gandhak Rasayan, Talkeshwar Ras, Namkeshwar Ras, etc. Pathya Pathya is also very important while treating any skin disorder. So Pathya is Lahu Anvastiktu, Ras Shak, Anvangrit, Mixed, Bhallatak, Shalidhanya, Shashtik Dhanya, Yav Godhum, Ghee boiled with bitter substances such as Tiktaras Pradhanvrit, Priyangu, Mugdh, Masoor, Adiki, Jungle Maal, Trifla, Patol, Nimbu, Manduk, Parni. These are Pathya diet. Apathya includes Guru, An, Amlaras, Dahi, Dugdh, Fish, Anupama, Gur, and Tail. These are considered as Apathya. So this was all about the management of Shudra Rog. In next lecture, we will do some next Rog Chikitsa Varnan. Till then, goodbye, have a nice day.